Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial for RoboJax. My name is Ahmed Shamshiri. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how we can use this touchless infrared temperature sensor MLX90614 to measure the temperature without touching and display it on the screen, either as Fahrenheit, Celsius, Kelvin for ambient and for the object temperature, or on this larger LCD 2004. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. A separate video explaining this MLX90614 module with a data sheet and full explanation. The link for that video is below this video. I'm not going to go through that. In this video, we're going directly to showing you how to display the temperature on the screen. Currently, this is the 2004, which has 20 characters and 4 lines, and it can display the object and ambient temperature at the same time. You can set the unit from the code to display as Fahrenheit or Kelvin, whichever you prefer. Or using this LCD 1604 with 16 characters and 2 lines, where you can see now it shows the object and the ambient, and also if you want it can continuously showing in Kelvin and Fahrenheit. A separate video explaining the LCD, how to use this, and full detail and explanation. A separate video for that. Make sure to watch that video, and also make sure that you are able to display some text on it before coming to this video, and also make sure to watch and run the introduction video so you are able to measure the temperature touchlessly and display it on the serial monitor, and then come to this. Otherwise, you might have some issue and you don't know where is the problem. I provide you 2 codes. One would be for this module, so it can display on the same time object and ambient temperature for the selected value, either Celsius, Fahrenheit, or Kelvin, and the code that will display, let's say, for Celsius object and ambient, just rotate. And if you select Fahrenheit, you can do Fahrenheit or Kelvin. Now let me explain the wiring. For the module, I'm going to show you to use it with the display using the same Arduino. And the module, because this works with a 3.3 volts here from this side, from the module, this is VCC, it has been connected to 3.3 volts. The next pin is ground, it has been connected to ground of Arduino. And then this is SCL and SDA, white and black have been connected here to SCL and SDA. And for the LCD, this is ground have been connected here to ground of Arduino. The next one is VCC, it has been connected using red wire to this 5 volts of Arduino. Then orange is SDA, it has been connected here to A4. And last one is SCL, clock pin, it has been connected to A5. If for some reason you need to connect multiple of different devices with I2C, or you can connect it to breadboard, and from breadboard connect it to the sensor and to the module, doesn't matter, because on the same line you can connect up to 128 different devices. So you can connect them all in parallel, that's okay. So there is no difference between the two. If you need the wiring diagram for this, it is available as part of my Arduino course at udemy.com. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects, all course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description. Now let me explain the code. The first thing that you need to do is download the library for the Maraxis. You should have watched the introduction video for this, and by now you should have already installed the driver for this, the library, and the library for the LCD. I'm not going to go through that. This line refers to the Adafruit library, which you should have downloaded and installed it. If not, watch the video. And here, these are the two texts that we display on the LCD. And here's this text. So you can put your own text in any language that you wish. So object and ambient. And this is the address for this module, because this has I2C module here and it has four wires. For that, you need to have the address. I will provide you the I2C scanner. You will copy and paste it. I will give you this code, copy and paste it, and upload it to your module. After uploading the code, simply open the serial monitor. So this is the serial monitor, and it shows these two addresses. One address belongs to the LCD, the other belongs to this one. Now, to get the address for this one, because we need it, let's disconnect this module. I'm just disconnecting these two wires here from the right side, and you will see the address is displayed for one of them. So this is now the address for the LCD 0x3f. And if I put this back, you will see that it shows two addresses. So the other one is 5A, is the I2C address for this. Make sure to get the address. Now I'm closing this and closing this. So type whatever address you get. This 0x mean hexadecimal, and that is the address. So put that. This 16 is referring to number of characters. If you count it, it will be 16, and 2 means 2 lines. So we will enter 2 here. This is the text that it will show you on the screen here. This is that text if you want to customize it or change it. And if you want to print the temperature in Celsius, print temp, and then inside single quotation put C, capital C. It must be capital, otherwise it will not work. And if you want to just show it the temperature, the object temperature in Celsius, and do not want to show anything, then delete everything inside the loop, all of this that I highlighted. So just leave this one, and every 2 seconds it goes and reads it for you. This is because that was Celsius. After C, I just used D, that is for ambient temperature. And then we have Fahrenheit, and after F, it was G, that's the ambient, and this is the object. So the first one, this is the object temperature that you're pointing to. And the same way, Kelvin, and after K, L, L is the ambient. So I use the next letter so you don't make mistake, and the first letter is the actual character that is used for that temperature unit. And we have 2 minutes in between them, 2 seconds in between them. And if you want to do some action based on amount of temperature, for example, you want to check if the temperature in Celsius is greater than 40 and you want to do something, this is a function, and do whatever you want to do is here. For example, turn on a relay or something, or a buzzer if the temperature is above, equal, or less than. So change this accordingly. Now let me demonstrate it. It shows now the temperature in Kelvin, Fahrenheit, Celsius for ambient and for the object. And this value that you have, you might not need it. So let me change the code so you can get only Celsius. This line, it says Celsius. This C, the D is also Celsius for the ambient. I'm going to comment this, the rest out by selecting them like that, and then right click comment. When I click comment, it will add these forward slash and let me upload it. Code is uploaded. It shows infrared, and now it shows in Celsius for object and ambient, and it just rotates and it does the same thing. So you can do the same way for Fahrenheit or other units or Kelvin if you want. And here it now shows my body temperature 31.95, and let me get closer. 33.57. Let me just hold it. 33.6. 33.57. So it's very steady. And let me point it to the surface. So object is 26 degrees and ambient is 28, so this surface is maybe cooler because I was touching it. Uploading the code. I have separate code for this, so I don't have to modify the code for the values. And here, right now, I've set it to temperature, so it shows object and ambient simultaneously. Light off. That's how you see it. 33.4. So you can select different units, Fahrenheit or Kelvin as well, and both of these will be displayed at the same time on the LCD. Thank you for watching a tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And to get updates of my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. If you want to learn Arduino, I have a bestseller course on Udemy where you can learn Arduino from ground up with hundreds of projects. All course material, library, codes, wiring diagram, everything available in one place. The link for my Arduino course is below this video in the description.